Why do I have to say this, brothers and sisters? Because witchcraft persistently attempts to deny our liberty, and in an infinite number of ways demands that we must work for our liberty. Witchcraft has its life in promoting dead works. Dead works not emanating from a faith relationship with God. I'm so tired of seeing young men and young women called of God, ordained, anointed of God to do his work, do witchcraft entrapment with the sole purpose of them not being able to fulfill their destiny in Christ. In light of this understanding, I believe that in order to discern the spirit of witchcraft, we must first be reminded of the totality of our gift of freedom through faith in Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Paul, in his epistle to the Galatians, reveals the above truth when he writes the following. You foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? Who has maligned you and fascinated you with false representations? Before whose eyes Jesus Christ was publicly portrayed, evidently set forth as crucified. That's Galatians 3:1 in the New American Standard Bible. Clear from this verse of scripture that bewitchment has its identity only through a portrayal or evidence of Jesus the Christ crucified. So the question would be, what does witchcraft have to do with Jesus crucified? Excuse me. Listen, the primary goal of witchcraft is to do detriment to the freedom rendering power of the cross. Witchcraft works against and speaks against the liberty freely given through faith. Witchcraft has its root in dead works. Dead works emanate not from communication with God, brothers and sisters, hear me this morning, but from a person's own desires.